It is in the woods and flowers and tall grass. It is in the lake and creeps along the trail beside me. I hear it whispering in the rustling leaves. Its power touches everything and changes everything it touches. I feel it reaching out for me. Nothing can stop it. Nothing is immune from its silent embrace. I can't get away from it. It's cancer.
Hi there. What's your name?
Ryan Rafferty.
Rafferty, huh? I'm Dr. Merritt. Rafferty, there you are. You're in Senior Boys.
Yeah, I know.
I saw you walking into the woods. What are you doing out here?
Nothing.
Oh, we don't allow that here. Come on, I'll walk back with you. Come on, you don't want to miss my speech. It's always good for a laugh.
Gotcha, huh? Don't worry about it. Nobody ever escaped from Camp Hawkins.
All right, everybody. Welcome to Camp Hawkins. For those of you who were here last year, our first year, welcome back. You'll notice a few improvements. Like trail bikes. And enough hot water for the showers. This is a camp. It is not a cancer ward with trees. We are here to have fun. So don't expect any head groups. The only thing that we're going to shrink is your laundry. You laugh. Wait till you see your underwear. Speaking of which, it's time for you to go back to your cabins and get unpacked. Your counselors will take you down to the dock for your swimming test later this afternoon. And then comes the high point of first day. Blood tests at the infirmary. I knew you'd say that. All right, come on. Everybody, let's go.
Hey, Ryan, wait up. Your cabin's over that way. Tyler. Okay, guys, let's try to finish up the unpacking. Right now, let's talk about a bunk name and a banner. Any ideas? Lewis?
How about the Key Boss?
How about the Cool Cats?
The Cool Cats? I don't get it.
Like in CAT scan, everybody here's had a CAT scan, right?
What name would you like?
The Wimps?
The Buddhas.
We can't be the Buddhas.
Why not?
Because I'm Lutheran.
Well, how about hair today, gone tomorrow? Come on, guys, look. I paid my dues.
Any of you ever consider something simple? Like maybe the Vikings or the aliens?
Ooh.
No way.
No way, Jose.
Well, I'm waiting. That's true. Princes in Exile. I think it sucks.
I like it.
Me too.
Let's vote. All for Princes in Exile?
Yeah.
What have you got against it, Robert?
My name is Princes in Exile.
It's called a metaphor. That might have occurred to you if you ever read a book.
Is that right?
All right, that's settled. Majority rules. Now, who's going to make the banner?
I'm not too good at art.
I will.
All right, Lewis. Okay, everybody, swimsuits. Time for the swim test.
All right, senior boys. I want you to swim out to the dock and back so I can see your strokes. What are you waiting for?
Maybe you should read up on swimming.
Attention, junior boys. The swimming instructor is waiting for you at the swim dock. Junior boys, please report to the swim dock immediately.
It's all done. Okay, you're out of here. Hi.
Thanks.
Blood test?
Yeah.
Have a seat. What's your name?
Ryan Rafferty.
Hi, I'm Marlene Lancaster.
Hi.
Hey, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
It's 1, 2, 3. Hold this.
Well, thanks.
Don't mention it.
She is beautiful, but she looks 23 and probably dates neurosurgeons. I'm 17, nearly bald and dying.
Dream on, Romeo.
Camp Hawkins, Hawkins, make yourself a friend. A smiling face is just around the bend. Camp Hawkins, Hawkins, make yourself a friend. Clap your hands, let's sing it all again. Put your hands together, sway your hips and stomp your feet. Things are getting better, can you feel it in the beat? Look right through the fire, you'll see a smiling face. Because your search is over, you finally found the place. Camp Hawkins, Hawkins, make yourself a friend. Clap your hands, let's sing it all again.
Very good for your first time. I just want to tell you before you go back to your cabins that we have two long-term projects at Camp Hawkins. There's skit night at the end of the session, and there's something new that we're trying this year. It's a camp sculpture. It's meant to be a monument to this year's campers. Now, everyone will be involved in one or the other. Skit night or sculpture, it's up to you. The staff won't be involved in any way. This is yours alone. Okay, let's call it a night.
Hey, guys.
Check this out. Check
if you got a gun, you don't need a lawyer. Freedom. If you got a gun, you don't need a lawyer. Freedom. Listen to the people. They want to be free. Free.
Lose virginity, publish journal, my two life goals. For the sake of posterity, I should at least reverse the order. But what the hell? Posterity will have to take me, warts and all. I've made progress on my second goal. 82 pages since I started this journal, right after I was diagnosed. But I'm afraid nothing to report on the first. My virginity is still intact.
What's that? It's my journal. Oh, what do you write? Just my thoughts. Hey, are you gonna do a skit or work on a sculpture? Neither. We have to do one. I'm gonna ask Holly to do a skit with me.
Who's Holly?
You haven't noticed her? She's the really cute one. I've seen your girls.
Huh?
Okay, princess. Let's get ready for bed. Now, I want to explain one thing. This button. Anybody needs assistance, medical or otherwise, you push this, and someone will be here instantly. Clear? Where you been?
Just out for a jog, by the way. I haven't got a watch.
Okay, well, you'll have to get ready for bed in the dark. Lights out waits for no man. All right, princess. That's it. Nighty night.
Ryan, I'm kind of having some trouble coming up with the concept for this banner. Where'd you get the idea for Princess in Exile, anyway?
I don't know.
Ah, oh, come on, man. Give me some help here.
Well, what can I tell you? It is what it is.
Talk about it.
I've always wanted to be a doctor, right? Ever since I was a little kid. I would have been a great doctor. But now I'm not going to make it to medical school. It's like I could have been a king in this world. You know, all of us could have been. So we're like princes in exile.
So kind of like a prince standing in front of a castle with the drawbridge up.
Yeah. Yeah, something like that. If it isn't King Ryan, you always listen to what isn't your business? You get a date with Marlene yet? What's the matter? Too chicken shit to ask her? You don't have to put a burning stick in your mouth to prove you're not chicken. Well, unless you're an emotionally immature grandstanding glory hound. Oh, yeah? Why don't you come into the woods before dinner tonight? We'll see who's chicken.
Hi, Holly.
Hi. How did he get up there?
I think he shimmied up with his belt or something.
He's not really gonna jump, is he?
No way.
Well, he says he can do it.
Yeah, well, the law of physics say he can't.
Okay, all right, that's enough. Okay, guys, you ready for this?
Did you guys see that?
Hey, guys, get me out of here, will you?
Hey.
Oh,
right. Let's hear for the stuntman.
Stuntman.
How did he do that?
They do it in the South Sea Islands. As long as the rope is shorter than the distance to the ground, there's no danger.
Is that right? Let's see you do it then.
I don't need that kind of attention.
Stuntman! 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 Stuntman!
So what do you think?
I like it. It's great. Good stuff.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Holly.
Holly, right. Hi. I'm Ryan.
Are you doing the sculpture or a sketch?
Neither if I can help it.
Why not?
Just not interested. Why?
Well, I was looking for someone to do a skit with. And I'm really interested in writing, and I hear you keep a diary.
It's a journal. Who told you?
Lewis. So what do you say? Are you interested?
Not really.
Well, excuse me for asking.
Hey! You're in luck. Marlene's on duty.
I'm just going to get my pills. Do you mind?
What is it you got, anyway?
Glioblastoma multiforme.
It's a brain tumor, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's bad.
It's in remission. What about you?
Acute lymphocytic leukemia? ALL, the guy's got it all, you know? But it's remission also. As far as I'm concerned, that's the way it's gonna stay. Listen, I know we started out butting heads. It's just, you got this attitude.
I got this attitude.
Yeah. Then what about you?
Better get in there. She's going off duty soon.
Hi. Got your pills on the counter there.
Did I keep you waiting?
No, just cleaning up.
You want some help?
No, that's all right. You don't have to.
Sure, I don't mind, really.
All right, then. You can clean off the counters.
I think it's really great that you volunteer here, especially since it's on your vacation.
I consider it a privilege. So, Dr. Mara tells me you want to be a doctor.
I don't want to be a doctor anymore.
No, why not?
Because it takes 11 years. I'm not expected to live through next Christmas.
Well, I...
Yeah. I guess I get a little morbid sometimes.
I understand. That must be tough. I know, I really admire your kids. Look at you, and then I look at my own trivial problems. And I feel ashamed.
You don't have to feel ashamed. You know, not with me.
Isn't it about time for cabin inspection?
Yeah, I guess so.
Okay, well, thanks for your help.
Sure, no problem. What's your image?
I change a lot. Yesterday, my cancer cells were cars, and I was crashing them into each other. Just now, they were mosquitoes, and I had a can of Raid.
If they're mosquitoes, you're losing the battle. Sorry.
It's all right. Have you ever tried visualizing?
Don't see the evidence for it, you know, medically speaking.
Well, I have Hodgkin's and it's really helped me.
What's the matter with you?
I'm fine. The camp is fine, the food is fine, the counselors are fine, the kids are fine, everything is fine. Why is it that I have to reassure my parents? Why aren't they reassuring me?
Yeah, tell me about it. As if we didn't feel enough guilt already.
The way my parents carried on? You'd think they're the ones with the tumors. Oh, I would have come to this place if it wasn't any better than a prison camp. Just to get away from them for a while.
Yeah, mine weren't gonna let me come at all. I had to threaten to kill myself if they didn't.
Let's go. Come on, kids. Yeah, up and around. That's it. That's it. Up and around. All right, let's go.
Hey, are you okay?
Yeah.
What happened?
These bikes are underpowered compared to what I'm used to.
What's he used to? Rocket sleds?
How you doing? You got a skip partner yet?
Not yet. But I know what I'm gonna do it on.
Oh?
It's gonna be a spoof of doctors, parents, and visitors to a kid in the hospital with a bone sarcoma. I think it can be hilarious. Sure you don't want to work on it with me?
Bone sarcoma, huh?
Yeah.
Is that what you got?
Yeah.
What's your prognosis?
Pretty good.
Well, I have a glioblastoma multiforme, otherwise known as incurable grade 4 astrocytoma. A brain tumor? What the hell is so funny about that? Rafferty, your real problem is you're a grade 4 asshole. What did Holly want? She wanted to know if I was still interested in doing a skit with her.
What'd you say?
I made her feel like shit.
Thanks.
Don't mention it.
They sleep during the day. Just be quiet, they won't bother you.
Hey, what about rats? I hate rats. Translation? You're afraid of
them. I suppose you like them?
I had a pet rat once. Take this one from the hospital. Okay.
Okay. Anybody claustrophobic? Seriously. Anybody afraid of the dark? All right. Let's go. Watch your step. Okay, those of you there, look out for bats.
First time being bald has ever been an advantage.
They said they weren't gonna bother us.
What kind of bats are they anyway?
Man-eating bats.
Hello? Hello? Hello?
Shut up! Wake them.
I propose a name change. Chickens in Exile.
Hey, listen, you guys. The senior girls did this yesterday.
All right, how far do we have to go?
You'll see. Okay, everybody here? All right. We are now about to experience real darkness. Everybody ready? Lights out.
Relax, guys. It's only a mouse with wings.
Do you know where you're going?
I think I just felt another one.
Rick!
Come on, Rick. Where are you?
I think he's run out on us.
Why would he do that?
Because getting out of here is a challenge we're supposed to rise to.
Guys, this is a dead end. I think we're lost. How about we try climbing up through this crack?
Forget it. If it was that hard, Rick wouldn't have left us. Come on, let's just feel our way back along the wall.
I don't know if this is the right way.
Rick, where are you? Rick!
I wonder if this is what death is like, groping in darkness. Perhaps death is not groping at all, but belonging to the darkness, being part of it. Maybe groping in the dark is a better description of life.
Where's Ryan?
Guys, maybe we should go back for him. Yeah, he'll find his own way out. There's not any more bats.
The tunnel seems to be closing in, getting narrower. I'm beginning to feel claustrophobic, but in a strange way the feeling pleases me. It's almost a pleasure being scared of something that's outside my skull. I'm drawn to the sunlight, the light at the end of the long, dark tunnel. They say that's what you see when you die. Maybe this is my dress rehearsal for death.
Keep your chest in. We'll be out of here in 2 seconds, okay?
I can't move.
Okay. Okay. Just move your hips a little. Come on. Come on. Okay. Can you move?
Tug me.
Okay, come on. Come on. Come on. Okay. Are you all right? Can you move? Okay. 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 All right. Okay. 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 All right. Okay. Now out of here.
Okay, guys, give him some room. You all right? Just have a seat.
Thanks.
You okay? You had us worried there.
All right. Well, let's go.
Listen.
I don't hear anything.
Yes, you do. You're hearing silence.
You want to hear silence? You ought to come to our farm some night in winter. Yeah, it's never this quiet in the city.
The air doesn't smell like this either.
That is crap. You guys want to spend what's left of your life smelling the air.
What's bugging you?
Oh, it's just dumb.
Why not? This place gives me the creeps.
Why?
Everything grows so wild, uncontrolled.
It's like the whole world has cancer and doesn't let you forget it. Not for one goddamn second. The woods aren't like cancer. The woods are beautiful. Cancer isn't.
Thank you.
I can't jump a bike across this gorge.
Are you out of your mind? That's impossible.
Look, it's only 20 feet across. I got a 200-foot run-up. I got a soft bank to land on. It's a piece of cake. All you know is build a ramp for the take-off.
Why are you doing this? What are you trying to prove?
Hey, maybe you guys are satisfied with going to arts and crafts classes and toasting marshmallows. But not me, all right? I want more than that.
Like killing yourself.
Like not killing myself. I'm into beating death, not losing to it.
You beat death just by waking up in the morning.
It just doesn't cut it.
I think you're doing it just to show off.
Sure, I'm showing off. But I'd do it if no one was watching. Because death is watching.
All my life, I've analyzed everything I ever did before I did it. Maybe that's why the stuntman is starting to get to me. Whatever he wants to do, he just does it. Robert lives for the ride. I only live for the destination.
Hey, what's the matter?
Holly turned me down.
Why?
She says she already had a skit partner.
That was quick.
Yeah, well, I bet I'm funnier than whoever it is.
Hey, why don't you do the sculpture? That's what you'd rather be doing anyways, isn't it?
You think so?
Yeah, well, take a look at your banner. I mean, it's good stuff.
Thanks. Well, I kind of do have an idea for it already. The sculpture, I mean.
What is it?
A wall.
A wall?
Yeah. As big and ugly as we can make it. We'll use anything we can find. Logs, scrap metal, old fabric junk, you name it.
What's the point?
Well, see, it's kind of like a tumor, right? Growing formlessly. It's like the barrier we all face. And then at the end of this session, we'll burn the mother down.
Well, what about the fact that there's no monument to this year's campers after it's been burned down?
Well, see, that's sort of it. That's our monument. The absence of the wall.
That's conceptual art, Lewis.
All right, you guys, the door, take it around back to the other side, okay? Hey, come on, let's finish up. The two girls are coming in right after lunch.
Sick. Should see Dr. Merritt.
I'm all right, okay? Just keep it to yourself.
I know the symptoms.
Hey, it was just the food. Liver does it to me every time.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Just don't say a word to anyone, okay?
What's the matter?
I'm okay.
Just back up, I'll catch my breath.
Stuntman, where's the back?
I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm okay. What'd you do that for?
Just take it easy, Mark.
I'm okay.
What is it?
I'm okay.
Okay. I'm sure you are, Stuntman. Let's go down to the medical station and check it out.
Your white count is 200,000. I think we'd better take a ride into town, Robert.
What does that mean, Ryan? It's 20 times normal. It means Robert's had a relapse.
Bunk when things have stabilized.
You should have somebody there. Not just doctors.
I want him to come.
Get in.
What are they doing?
Try to relax now, Robert. The worst is almost over.
Is Ryan here?
Yeah, he's waiting outside.
I want to see him.
Only for a couple of minutes.
Don't get yourself all worked up. I'm sure Robert will be all right.
Don't do that, please.
Do what?
Why does everyone have to start lying? I mean, I know what's going on here. You're not sure. You can't be sure. So don't lie.
Ryan?
I'm sorry. What is this shit they're giving me? Fingerstein never made me sick like this. They can't go back to Fingerstein alone after a relapse. Tell me straight, Ryan. What's happening? They're trying to knock your white count back down with two really heavy drugs, but there are side effects.
Is it gonna work?
It usually does.
No doctor bullshit here, all right?
Hey, your chances are good. There's an overall 50% success rate with ALL.
doing?
Afraid that's it for the rest.
Okay. I'll come back tomorrow.
Don't. I don't want any visits here. I'll be back at camp before session ends.
Hang in there.
Lucky guy. Guess I drive all the way back with Marlene. Make sure you're in the back with her.
You bet.
Think of Stuntman lying in his hospital bed. But all I can think of is me. I remember when my tumor was diagnosed. I wasn't scared. I was so certain of my destiny that I couldn't conceive of not beating it. I figured the experience was meant to make me a better doctor, that's all. But it didn't go that way. The headaches got worse. The surgeons finally removed most of it, but not all of it. One of these days, I wake up with a headache again.
The 8-year-olds have made a giant card for Robert. And Dr. Merritt's gonna drive all the princes in at 3 to give it to him.
I said he didn't want anybody visiting him.
I think he'll be glad to see how much everyone cares.
Do you care?
Well, Robert? Of course I do.
Why don't you do what he wants?
Because that's not really what he wants.
What do you really get out of working here?
I find it fulfilling.
Fulfilling? Dealing with cancer is fulfilling?
I don't deal with cancer, Ryan. You do. It's a privilege to help you.
Do you really want to help me?
Of course I do.
I have 2 goals in life. Both of them I can accomplish this summer. One of them is completing enough good pages in that journal to have it published. And the other one is
to make love to me.
Oh, no. No, no, who told you that?
It's all right, Ryan. I got the message pretty quick. I want you to understand that I'm flattered. I'm even honored. But I can't do that.
Why? Because I have cancer? Because I'm dying?
No, Ryan. I wouldn't have that kind of relationship with anyone your age or anyone I was treating. It's unethical. You know that.
I don't have time for such ethical distinctions.
Yes, you do, Ryan. I'm sorry.
No, I don't want your pity.
It is not pity. I want to be your friend. Will you let me?
It's signed by everybody in the camp.
I don't even know everybody in camp.
Yeah, but everybody knows the stuntman.
How am I supposed to put that on my night table?
Well, I could always use it as an extra blanket.
Maybe they'll put it on the wall for me. Thanks, guys.
No problem.
I think it's time that we're heading back. See you soon, huh?
Bye, guys.
Take it easy.
Hey, guys. Can you do me a favor?
Sure, what?
When you're building that wall?
Yeah.
Will you divert some boards for me and build a ramp?
What for?
For my job. I won't have time to build it when I get back. Here are the plans. Can you understand them?
Well, it's not exactly the space shuttle, Robert. It's just a ramp.
Hey, the angle is critical. It has to be braced properly and spiked into the ground. Otherwise, I just push it into the gorge.
We'll do it.
Great. How about Marlene?
I can take a hint. Take it easy, stuntman.
You too, Lewis. So, how'd you make your move?
I made a move to...
Uh-oh. I guess you didn't exactly jump your bones.
Not exactly.
Did you kiss her at least? Just do it. Don't ask her. Just do it.
I can't do that.
Ryan, we're here for a good time, not a long time. Get out of here. The guys are waiting.
See you later.
Okay.
Were you spying on her?
What? Spying on who?
You were, weren't you? Were you in love with her or something?
Lewis told me you found yourself another skit partner.
I meant you. Just gonna give you one more chance.
Okay. I'll do it. But not a comedy, okay?
Fine. You do what you want, and I'll find a different partner.
Hey, why can't we be serious about cancer?
Because I don't want to be serious about it. I want it to be funny. Do you mind?
What's bugging you?
You and your self-pity, that's what. So what if you've got a grade 4 astro whatever? You know we're softer than anyone else. What do you think this is? A bandage?
There's one slight difference. You'll be here next summer. I won't.
You think you're the only one like that here?
Of course not.
What about the 8-year-olds who aren't expected to live another year? Why don't you feel sorry for them?
What are you talking about? I do.
No, you don't. You're too busy feeling sorry for yourself. So you won't live to be a doctor. I can just imagine what kind of a doctor you'd be. Your patients would wind up trying to make you feel better.
Looks good.
Lewis, can I ask you something?
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
My mother sent me this really odious navy. Can I nail it on the wall?
Sure. Go ahead. Like her. Why don't you grab a few of the guys and some boards and go start on the ramp now? I'm gonna build the ramp. But you promised him. Don't you think I know that? God, Lewis. Didn't you see him?
not coming back. So what would be the point?
I guess there isn't any point.
Come on in.
Hi, Ryan.
Sit down. Got a problem. I need your help.
What kind of problem?
Todd Hesquith. He's in the 8-year-old bunk. He has an abdominal lymphoma. Excellent prognosis, but he's convinced himself that he's possessed by a demon. Started to behave inappropriately, and I think the best way to calm him down would be to have that demon exorcised.
You're serious?
Mm-hmm.
Why me?
Because I think you can pull it off.
Oh, who's getting the therapy here? The kid or me?
Both of you. If you don't screw it up.
No. You're gonna need this.
You are possessed.
How did you know?
I can sense a demon within you. I am an exorcist.
You are?
You must be exorcised immediately. I will come for you at midnight. Be ready. Wear white. First realized you were possessed?
Well, my mother thinks it was after the doctor said I had cancer. But I always knew he was there. I just didn't say anything.
Why not?
Because he was supposed to be there.
Why?
To punish me.
What for?
Because I'm bad.
How do you know you're bad?
Because my father tells me.
Has a demon spoken through you yet?
I don't think so. Not out loud or anything.
Good, good. This means we detected it in time.
You think you can really get rid of it?
Yes. Yes, I do. Now lie down and put your head on that log. This demon didn't pick you because you're bad, you know that?
He didn't?
No. They're like viruses. You just pick them up being in the wrong place at the wrong time. Only they're very rare. You just got unlucky, that's all.
He didn't come looking for me?
Nah. He just found a nice place to live called Todd. And what I do is really more like an eviction. Are you ready?
Is this dangerous?
Sometimes, but this should be pretty routine.
Have you done a lot of exorcisms?
Through many lifetimes, child. Mine is an ancient spirit.
Wow.
I'll open your shirt. The tumor of yours is almost gone.
That's amazing. That's what Dr. Mirror told me. But I didn't believe him.
Uh-huh.
Is that holy water?
Even better. Distilled. I'll be quiet.
Dante, Da Vinci, Mussolini, Julius, Nero, Augustus, Octavia, Claudius, Tiberius, Cicero, Virgil. I command that the demon hiding in Todd Hesquith issue forth and quit him. In the name of the Holy Spirit and all that is right and good. Out, out, demon. And do not return.
That's it. Lie still for a couple moments to allow your body to adjust.
He's gone. I felt him leave. Boy, you're really a pro.
Just doing my job.
Hi. Hey, it's the Exorcist. Save any souls today?
You heard about that, huh?
So what do you want? A medal?
The other day you said I was insensitive and self-obsessed.
You are. You only did the exorcism to prove that you're not.
You're out of your mind. You know that?
Is that what you swam all the way over here to tell me?
I swam over here to tell you that I'll do the skit with you. Comedy, whatever you want.
Why don't you ask Marlene to do it with you?
Hey, look. You want to write a skit together or not?
I've already written it.
You have?
But you can make suggestions. If you have any.
All right. I'll read it when we get back from our overnight, okay?
Fine.
See you then.
Gurdip! Downtown! Jay, Gurdip!
Hey, Ryan. What are you always writing about, anyway?
Nothing. I bet it's porno.
Yeah, right.
Maybe he's a reporter doing a story on us in secret.
Yeah, or maybe he's a narc.
Maybe he's a spy for Merritt. He's writing shrink stuff about us. Do you write anything about me in there?
It's nobody's business what I write in here.
I thought you said you wanted to get it published, though.
You want to publish it?
Someday, yeah.
Well, then it's our business what you write about us.
It's not about any of you.
Why don't you read us some of it?
No.
I don't know about you guys, but I want to see what's in that journal.
Yeah.
Hey, 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 hey. Come on, give that back. Tyler.
Tyler. Woo!
What's going on?
They're trying to take his journal.
Hey, knock it off. Leave him alone. What the hell do you think you're doing? Get into your beds right now. That was real ugly. Brian has a right to privacy here, just like all the rest of you. What he writes in his journal is his business.
Not if he publishes stuff about us, it isn't.
I'm not writing about any of you. I'm writing about me. Just me. Okay?
Yeah, how do we know that?
Look, if you really have to know, I'll read parts out on the overnight. My brain was disappearing, and with it, my mind, myself. I listened to the clock by my bed and imagined the synapse exploding with each tick. Tick, tick, tick. Three thoughts gone. Tick, tick, tick. Three memories gone. I dozed and dreamt my roommate was a tumor. He was eating, and I asked him where he got his food. He showed me my brain on his plate and said, "From you." And I wasn't able to move because he had eaten my cerebellum. And I wasn't able to breathe because he had eaten my brainstem. And I will never forget the panic I felt, to fear that I was not only dying, but was losing my ability to reason as well. I tried to summon confidence, but it was futile. I was slowly sinking into nothingness, into the cold emptiness of non-existence.
That's a pile of shit.
Why do you want to publish that?
What do you mean, why?
Well, if it's all like that, it's really kind of a downer.
Yeah, so I'm a cancer victim. What do you want, Walt Disney?
Books and movies about people with terminal diseases are usually about how they get the most out of life.
This is my journal, not Terry Fox's.
But you still have to be positive.
I am being positive. I will want my journal to help others.
How is that shit gonna help anybody?
It'll help them to overcome their illusions and learn to accept death.
You haven't accepted death. You think the world's let you down, everybody's failed you. That's what I heard in that writing. You're not giving anybody anything, Ryan. You're taking.
Ryan. Turn that off.
Come back.
Just get out of here, all right?
You're a really good writer, Ryan. You really are. It's just that, I don't know, it's just that you have to do something.
Did I tell you? I'm not gonna work on the sculpture anymore. I'm gonna do a skit with Holly.
You bastard.
Look who's talking. I'd like you to read these pages of my journal. It should only take 10 minutes.
Okay.
Tell me what you think. Be brutal.
Aren't I always?
I'll wait outside.
You're a compelling writer. You just have to mature a little, that's all.
Great. Got a lot of time for that.
Yeah, you can mature overnight if you want.
Please, no therapy, okay? Just tell me straight.
I know you meant this to be a benefit to others. How do you think it's going to help them?
It'll help them face reality.
So if you were a doctor, you'd just tell patients with serious illnesses that they were going to die. Just a matter of time.
You wouldn't?
Well, sometimes people do beat the odds, Ryan. Who am I to take away their hope? Hope helps. Despair doesn't. Your own chances are slim. But slim is better than none.
It's terrifying how fast it can happen. Robert's white count hasn't dropped. The drugs aren't working. No more magic.
Hey. Hey. Did you do it? Do what? Kiss her. don't believe it. You're such a wimp. I can't do it. Actually, I don't want to do it. Anyway, I think I'm getting interested in Holly. Huh. Yeah, I'm doing a skit with her. It's about how funny it is to have cancer.
It was her idea.
As long as you end up in the sack.
Yeah, right.
Anyway, how are you making out?
I've been having a ball. I collected those little ketchup envelopes, you know? I got out to do a really good hemorrhage. And so I called the nurses in, and I used to see them, they almost shit themselves.
That's great stuff, man. You started the rap yet?
Yeah, we're about halfway.
Well, you could stop there.
What are you talking about?
I lied. I haven't done any stunts or anything like that. Just been lying here turning into mattress lint. Don't waste any more time on it.
Is there anything I can do for you?
Yeah.
Name it.
Don't lie to me. You're the only one around here that hasn't got smiles on me. I'm counting on you.
I was straight with you about the treatment the night they brought you in here, wasn't I?
I know. I just want you to keep it that way.
I gotta go, stuntman.
Say hi to everyone.
You said you weren't gonna work on the sculpture.
I'm not.
Gonna build a ramp. So why'd you change your mind?
If the ramp exists, then it's possible for Robert to jump the gorge. And if it doesn't, then there's no way he can. Right?
No, I guess not. All right, so, where's your 2x4s and 1-inch planks?
Round back.
I felt that you had the right to know immediately. Robert died at 3:45 this morning. He slipped away peacefully in his sleep. Decided how I'm going to tell the younger kids, and I'd appreciate it if you'd all just follow your normal schedule for the rest of the day and not discuss it with the others yet.
Look, I don't want to fight anymore.
Yeah. I was gonna apologize. Then I thought maybe we're better off this way. Maybe it's better not having friends.
I mean, you can't stop liking people, Ryan.
Really want me as a friend, Lewis? And go through this all over again?
Well, it's better than turning off. I mean, that's just dying in slow motion.
Life is risky. Sometimes it's short. But a short life is not necessarily an unsuccessful one. To dwell on Robert's death instead of his life would do him a disservice. It won't bring him back. And it won't help you. I'd like to ask a friend of Robert's to come and say a few words. Ryan?
He was a daredevil. And at first I thought he was nuts. But he was alive every moment. Well, most of us are only sometimes alive. I don't want to make a long speech. I'll only say what he would have wanted me to say. And that is that we should get on with the business of living. For me right now, that seems impossible without his example. I miss you, Robert. But I'm glad you're free.
Let's see, I have to break this to them tactfully. Your son Timmy has brain cancer, but there's no need to be alarmed.
Oh, my God. Why me? I've been such a good mother. Where did I go wrong? Where?
Oh, it's not you, darling. He got it from our genes.
Not from our Calvin Kleins, he didn't.
Like you guys, the widow's.
What's the matter with me, Doc?
Acne. Very bad case. Internal acne.
What about this bump on my head?
It's a zit. A big one. We'll have to operate.
Level with me, Doc. How long have I got?
Well, what's this you're reading, War and Peace?
I think I better get you a short story.
Son, this here is Dr. Warpdrive from the University of Mars. He's here to cure you.
I have a spaceship waiting to take you back. Our medicine is light years ahead of yours, and we can cure you by starting you from birth.
Out! This way, interns. This is Timmy. Timmy has brain cancer.
Ooh, that's cold.
Coriander, take his blood. Coriander, you missed the vein. That's okay. Try again. Everybody, try again. Practice makes perfect.
Hey, you're supposed to be taking care of me.
We are. We can treat you for symptoms. We can turn your body inside out with drugs and bore holes in you with radiation. But I'm afraid we can't care for you. Technology hasn't advanced that far.
Dad? Dad!
Yes, son. Here I am. Don't panic. What is it?
Is it too late for that spaceship?
Just when I had begun to accept the fact that I would probably die unpublished and a virgin, along comes Ollie. I think maybe I'm falling in love with her. I don't want her to make love to me out of pity.
I like you a lot.
But I do want us to make love together.
I like you too.
And I tell her that.
Tomorrow, after the wall burning, it's last night, no one will care.
You mean?
Burn the wall, let's
One day we'll reach out and touch the sky. Touch the sky.
I'll be right back.
So what do you think?
I love it. It's great.
Thanks.
Nice work, Lewis.
No, this kid is really funny. You're a good writer.
Think so?
You're very funny.
Thanks.
Excuse me.
Jumping a creek.
Why did you burn your journal?
Because it was full of anger and self-pity. Never would have helped anyone. It was wrong. All wrong.
Did you save any of it?
No, I'd rather start from scratch.
Well, I guess it's a good thing.
It's a great thing. It's a load off my back. So let's celebrate.
It's not cool now. They'll notice we're gone and look for us.
Find us?
I've got a better idea. We'll go back to our cabins. You pretend you're getting ready for bed and lay down and everything.
Mm-hmm.
Then, when everyone's asleep, sneak out to my cabin.
No way. That is a good idea. See that?
All right, I hate to do this. This party is officially over. All right? I know, It's 2 o'clock in the morning.
So what?
Lights out.
Hey, Rick.
What?
Can we tell ghost stories?
Fine.
Let's do it. So, who wants to go first? Tyler, you got some good ones. Have I told you guys the one about the killer vampire that sucks the blood out of these kids at a summer camp and then stuffs them with straw?
Yeah, you told us that one.
Have I told you the one about the old bull and the young bull?
Oh,
yeah, shut up.
Rafferty, he's sneaking around outside.
Yes?
He's home. Nice going, Rafferty. Everybody in the bunk knows we're out here together.
I blew it, didn't I?
There'll be other times.
Thanks. Thanks for everything.
Will you write to me?
I like that.
Well, so long, friend.
Hope to see you next year with any luck, huh?
I hope so. Take care. Can I speak to you for a minute?
Yeah, sure.
Do you know it's full moon tonight?
Yeah, I always know that.
I need you to tie me down tonight.
Excuse me?
I think I'm a werewolf.
Why do you think that?
Look at that. There's more hair than there was before, and I feel different. I feel like biting and growling, and I don't want to hurt anyone.
You don't need me to tie you down. Werewolf prevention can be done on your own. Before you go to bed, take an ice cube, rub it on the back of your hand. Put your pajamas on inside out, then sleep backwards. Do this for the next 2 full moons. If it doesn't work, call me. But it will. It always does.
Well, thanks. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Todd.
Man. Well, I hope you're going to start another journal.
I don't know.
Why not write about the last few weeks?
Sure you want to risk that?
I'll take my chances. Whatever you write, please send me a copy. I'm interested.
I will. Thank you, Dr. Merritt.
All right, campers. All of you going downtown, please get on bus number 1. And all of you that are going to the airport, move down to bus number 2.
Hi there.
Hey, we gonna be able to ride back together?
All the way. Just don't kiss me when we get off the bus. My parents will be there.
I hate myself.
It'll happen.
Sure it will.
Why not? We'll keep in touch, won't we?
I don't want to keep in touch. I want to touch.
You can visit on weekends.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure your parents will love that.
They would. They'll be happy I have a friend from here.
You sure they won't suspect anything?
Who would suspect a boy with brain cancer?
Good point.
Then turn the page. I'll see you there. So.
Bye, guys. Have fun. Bye-bye.
I want to impress these last scenes on my mind. I want to understand why everything looks so different. These are the same trees, the same lake, the same sky I saw when I came. But I don't see any malignancy in them anymore. Everything is pure, clean, beautiful. Nothing can spoil it. Whatever it was I saw then was in me and isn't anymore. In that sense, I'm cured.